We got a whole lot to get into this week, but I told Eric I was gonna let him just go in because I know him, along with my dad and all the other Knicks fans out there that has been waiting for 40 plus years for them to get back to the promised land. You know, are excited this week, so I wanted to give Eric his time. He's been having his time this whole season, but you know, the Knicks are in fourth place right now. You know, Julius Randle has got his first All-Star selection, so I said, you know what, Eric, go ahead, have your moment.
I've got to say, man, it's a great feeling, man. It's a great feeling. I've been waiting. Shout out to your dad. Shout out to all the Knicks fans everywhere. You know, we ain't had a good team in quite some time. 2013 was the last good team we had with Melo when we was the number two seed. So it feels good, man. Like you said, we got an all-star. We're the number four overall seed right now. Or fourth seed in the East, I should say. Let me not get ahead of myself. Fourth seed in the East. Still a lot of basketball to be played. But as I've said all season, if the season ended today, if it ended today, we would be the number four seed hosting a home game, hosting a first round home playoff round. So it's just an exciting time around the Garden, man. And it's great for the city, no matter how you feel about a trip. And you notice yourself, it's a different energy around New York City when the Knicks are relevant.
No,
when the Knicks are relevant, it's a different energy.
It is. And I will say this, because, you know, listen, y'all know I give the Knicks enough grief because I'm not a Knicks fan. I am a fan of my city, though. And I will support that. You know what I mean? I've been to the, you know, me and Eric have been to the ballroom at the Garden on numerous occasions. You know what I'm saying? So I'm okay with them doing well. I think what it is for me mostly is, see, I would have to, you know, with our previous co-host, He was so much of a LeBron hater that it would make me go in on the Knicks, even on during times where I was like, I really didn't want to go in on them. But I just because he was such a LeBron hater, it would make me go there with the Knicks because it's like you can't hate on LeBron and your team is in the trash. So I would just say these outlandish things. But even, you know, and I've said on the show, you know, one of the reasons why I dislike Paul Pierce so much is because of that nonsense that he did at the Garden. He started bowing and running laps around the Garden off a regular season win of a Knicks team that was probably one of the worst Knicks teams that we've seen during this whole drought. You know what I mean? So, you know, and I got real overprotective of the Knicks at that point. So it's not really that I hate the Knicks or anything like that. It's just, you know, if you disrespect my guys, I got to come back at you in a way that's going to get to you. But I'm happy.
Fair enough. You're right. And you know, and I get that. You know, sometimes, you know, the sports fan who isn't as knowledgeable, who just likes to throw a bunch of you know what against the wall and hope something stick, yeah. You know, they'll take jabs at certain guys. You can't listen, no matter how much sports I claim to know, one thing I will always admit is LeBron James is an all-time great. So if you're trying to cover up for how bad the Knicks have been by taking jabs at LeBron, I mean, that's just a terrible angle to take in the first place. But for anybody who isn't from New York, I know we get a lot of support from other places throughout the country and even internationally as well. There are two things about New York City at particular times of the year. And in the fall, when the Yankees are a World Series contender, and during the spring when the Knicks are a playoff team, those are two feelings within the city that you have to be in the city to understand. Because like I said, when the Knicks are relevant and playing meaningful games late in the season, there's a different energy around the city. Again, 2013, when Melo led us to the number two seed, there was a different feel around the city because that team was good and they were going toe-to-toe with Miami during the regular season and people had hope that they would see each other in the playoffs.
Absolutely.
And same thing with the Yankees. I'm not a Yankee fan, never been a Yankee fan, but I will never deny the buzz that's within the city come October when the Yankees are playing in an ALCS or even in a World Series. It's a different feeling around the city. You got to respect it. And, you know, for Knicks fans, and I think a lot of them will agree with me on this, as bad as we want to have a superstar, you know, we never had a LeBron James. We've never had a Kevin Durant.
Yeah.
More importantly, we just wanted some confidence.
Like, we got to give our respect to Patrick Ewing.
Oh, no, right. Okay. But
since Patrick
I'm saying, we okay. Never had the best player. We had good players, right?
Patrick was great, but he was never the best player. I mean, I got to think at that time was Pat. I mean, I Maybe top five. Maybe Pat was in the top
possibly. He was top 10 for sure. Yeah, he was definitely top 10.
But I'd have to do my research to see if he was really top five during his prime years. But
right.
You know, but he definitely top 10. I wouldn't put him out of the top 10.
Absolutely. And like I said, we've never had, you know, the number one guy, maybe not even a number two guy. I don't think Melo was number two when he was here. He was a top five player, but he wasn't a number two. You know, he wasn't the second best player in the league. But I'd like to say this, what we really wanted was competent basketball. And having Thibodeau come in, and it shows you why coaching matters. Yeah. A guy who comes in, these are all the same pieces from last year.
You did say that.
Yeah.
When they announced Thibodeau.
Coaching matters. These are all the same pieces from last year. And yet Julius Randle looks like an all-star now. RJ Barrett is starting to take that leap now. You know what I'm saying? Our number one pick ain't even really played that much, but yet the team has been better overall because of what Tibbs has brought to the table. And then adding a veteran like Derrick Rose helps us as well. So I'm just super excited for what we got going on in the Garden, man. But let's get to it. I know we got a lot of topics to get to today.
Well, really quick, I do want to, because you mentioned the Knicks first round pick, Obi Toppin. He hasn't really gotten his groove yet because he did start off the season banged up. So he hasn't really gotten to a groove. But he will be in the dunk contest. And I'm looking forward to that. And part of the reason I'm looking so forward to that is because I'm still kind of upset that we didn't get to have Shump in the dunk contest that year because he was supposed to jump over Jeremy Lin sleeping on the couch. So I'm excited to see another Knicks player in the dunk contest this year. And I'm also excited that the Knicks are in the playoffs because, to be honest with you, you know what I'm saying, as a Nets guy, I want to see Knicks versus Nets. Now, granted, I know the teams are very uneven right now.
Right. So we're not on that level.
Yeah. So I don't expect the Knicks to win, but I think we're finally getting to that point where we'll see the Knicks and the Nets both in the playoffs yearly. And, you know, we'll get to see that rivalry go back and forth. So I'm looking forward to it.
And we got to, as Knicks fans, I'm going to speak on behalf of the Knicks delegation. We want to thank Kevin Durant too, because Kevin Durant openly said, ain't nobody checking for the Knicks. They not popular. None of that's happening. Now the Nets are better than us, but yet all the headlines have been about the Knicks.
Yeah.
Again, nobody's doubting what they are capable of doing. We know we expect them to be competing for a championship, but it's ironic that the moment that we just get slightly relevant, we're not a powerhouse, we're not a championship contender, just slightly relevant. People are more excited about what the Knicks are doing than the Nets. I'm just going to leave that out there, but let's get to it, man.
Because at the end of the day, this is still, the Garden is still, you know what I'm saying, the mecca of basketball, and, you know, the Nets would still have to win a championship to take away from that. So as good as they are now, they had some good years during the Garnett, Paul Pierce years, you know what I mean? But and you're not going to take that spot away from the Knicks when we've seen for years the Knicks continue to sell out no matter what. There's always a Knicks headline. So you can't take that spot away without winning a championship. You win a championship for the city, then things will start to shift, and it's still going to be hard to really take away from what the Knicks mean to New York. They've been here from the beginning. They're one of the first teams. So it's gonna be a little harder to just replace that, but a championship does help. And at least they are in position to win a championship if they can, you know, actually keep all three guys on the court at the same time. They have a good chance.